Introducing Ada Lovelace. She was the first computer programmer, and she died when she was only 36.
Here's me in my cot, with my abacus, getting a head start. I'm really clever. I'm going to be a math sensation, and I got an education, which most girls didn't in my day. Where did I get those brain cells from? Right here. My mother Annabella, extremely religious, a bit square, very clever and totally uptight. How she got together with my father, Lord Byron, I don't know. He liked her brains, I think. He was a real catch, handsome, a cool poet and writer, and very popular with the girls. In fact, a total hunk. But he had a terrible temper, and he drank a lot. Well, that didn't last long. Old Byron cleared off before I was a year old, and he never saw me again. Thanks a lot, mate. Mum didn't want me growing up like my dad. She thought he was nuts. So when I was still tiny, she fixed me up with a really strict tutor who drilled me in maths, astronomy, algebra, geometry, oof. And as if that wasn't bad enough, she threatened me too. Said if I didn't work hard, I'd be locked in a dingy, cold room full of cobwebs.
10 out of 10, or otherwise it's in the cupboard with you.
Charles Babbage was one of the big science celebrities in my day. He was a general brain box, mathematician, philosopher, inventor, engineer. A polymath is what they call it, as well as having a name that rhymes with cabbage. My old teacher, Mary Somerville, was a friend of Mr. Babbage, and so I wangled invitations to his little show-and-tell parties, where he told us about his calculating machine, the difference engine, the first machine made to calculate numbers. This is a model he built. People say it was the first computer, but it had to be powered by steam and turned with a handle. We didn't have batteries or electricity when I was around. Well, I was totally knocked out by it, and I wasn't the only one. The writer Charles Dickens, the famous nurse Florence Nightingale, Michael Faraday, the inventor of the motor engine, and even Charles Darwin all thought it was pretty amazing too. Mr. Babbage then designed an even more complicated machine called the analytical engine. This was the first real computer because it was designed to calculate not just numbers, but to do other difficult tasks, even composing music.
The only explanation of this machine was in French, and I translated it and added my own notes about this exciting new computer. And my totally new and original thought was that it could follow a step-by-step series of operations to solve problems, what we call an algorithm. That's why I'm known as the first computer programmer. Because until then, no one had understood this. My notes were 3 times longer than the original. Everyone was very impressed. Listen, there are a couple of things I didn't tell you, because I'm keeping it short, but I got married and I managed to have 3 children.
But my whole life long, I'd always been rather sickly and weak. And when I was only 36, I became very seriously ill. If you're squeamish, block your ears, because in my day, doctors thought that bloodletting was a good idea, where they cut open your veins and let your blood out, because they thought that was the problem. Of course I didn't survive, and I had so much more to do, but I'm glad that my name lives on today as the woman known as the first computer programmer. Don't forget me. Yeah!